I get up to her and I open the bag up. She looks in, sticks her hand down in it. I thought, oh God, she's gonna open this manila envelope that has all these vials in it. I just thank God she never opened that envelope. She takes her hand out, says, go on. At that point, I was through one stage of the return trip. I knew if I got through the Dallas airport, we were home free. We're literally running out of time. I was thinking, okay, what is our next option should I make it to our customs in Dallas and I get stopped there? I was more worried they were gonna search me because I had flown down and back in a day. I was towards the end of it and the guy looks at me and he goes, man, you look beat. And I said, I am. I just wanna go home and go to sleep. And he just stamped my thing and sent me on through. It's done. I'm on my way to Steamboat.
I told Mikey. I said, yeah, your dad's got the meds, and he'll be here tomorrow.
And to me, that just really showed me how much he really does care and how good of a dad he is. My dad walked back into the hospital room. And I was like overjoyed. I'm just like, yeah, man. It's gonna be finished, over with. I was just looking forward to being normal again.
Susie and I are at that moment of relief, except that the only thing we know about this anti-venom is what the people in the airport have told us and what we've researched about it. Doctor still doesn't know how Mikey's gonna react to it.
The procedure to inject the anti-venom had to be done outside of the hospital.
The hospital had refused to have this drug on their grounds, let alone be administered on their grounds. The doctors own their offices in the other building. They don't own anything in the hospital. It's its own entity. And so they set the rules on that side of the wall. The doctor's assistant comes wheeling up a crash cart. And I was like, why are you bringing this? And she goes, well, we don't take any chances. Susie and I looked at each other and she asked, are we doing the right thing?
Thoughts go through your head like, well, how safe is this stuff really from a foreign country?
Mikey could, you know, have permanent nerve damage any part of his body. How do we prevent it from happening? So yeah, it was going through our mind that Mikey was, to us, in danger, in serious danger.
I hope to God that we have made the right decision.
He started injecting it into Mikey, and at that point, it was a matter of waiting.
It was about 20, 25 minutes went by, and my arm started tingling. And then it went slowly down into my lower back and my legs and everything.
Mikey's legs started quivering, like a ripple effect, and you're like going, what is that?
doctor said, it's the neurotoxins releasing from your nerves. They're letting go.
I just vividly remember the pain just slowly, slowly, slowly going away.
Hour into it, he stood up.
They're just like, well, I don't think he can walk yet, but I'm just like, no, I think I can.
And he walked 5 feet and said, does it hurt? And Mike's like, no, don't feel anything.
I mean, I just started into tears. It was amazing how fast and how thorough that stuff worked.
It's like nothing ever happened to him.
It felt like a bird released from a cage. I felt like I was becoming myself again.
Within an hour, he was discharged.
We had all of our family back again.
I said, thanks, Dad. And he's just like, you know, you don't need to say thanks to me. That's my job. I'm your dad. You know, that's what I do. Since the bite, I'm back doing stuff that I normally do. I can tell you, I check my socks every day.
This
is gonna be green and purple.
This whole ordeal showed us as a family what can be accomplished when somebody really sets their mind to it.
I think I'm really special to have a dad like mine. I mean, for him to just be willing to go to Mexico, do all this stuff for me, you know. Not many people have that type of a dad where they're willing to do that stuff for him.
It's that need to have the family unit, that need to keep the unit together and not have one part gone.